Welcome to Indo Indians.
Hi Poonam, how are you?
Very good. In fact, I wanted to introduce Abha to Indo Indians because Abha is India's first woman motivational speaker of international acclaim, rated as one of the top 10 life, business and success coaches in Asia Pacific. Wow, Abha, that's a huge mouthful, and I think it's a huge lifetime achievement as well.
It is actually sometimes overwhelming to hear all this, but yes, it just started out as a purpose or a calling thing, and it reached this point when I had to, as a lawyer, I was a practicing lawyer, I'm a professional lawyer, and I decided to move to personal development and people's building because that's my core calling. I wanted to work around that, so I went to re-educate myself at the age of 34.
Wow.
And from there on, I have been doing things around this area, and that is where we've got so far, which is not bad at all.
And no, I think it's wonderful. You can't even say so not bad to that.
It's been quite a good sort of journey, and just started out with my wanting to be in the people's building field and wanting to make something out of it, and I wanted to have some businesses around that, and that's what I was working on. I'm still working on now. So yeah, that's where it comes from.
And you know, in that process, you've also written a best-selling book.
Yes. You want
yes,
to show you the book?
Yes, please show us the book.
So that's my book, and that's me on top with shorter hair. This is called Nucleus, and it's a 544-page super manual, which is, I call it a super manual because it's on leadership for women, and that topic cannot be covered in a 200-250-page book. So this basically gets women from the outside world expectation to themselves, build themselves, and then commit themselves into the outside world in the ways in which they can best contribute. Because
right.
Women across the world are living through a backdrop. I don't want to call it names, but there is a backdrop out there in which does not allow women to live their full kind of full self. So they keep fighting these little fights which probably are not even their own. So I sometimes feel it's our time. Why should we waste it on fighting with others? So that's where the book takes you. It gets you out from this outside expectation into your own core, into your own nucleus. Build yourself up. So there is a methodology there. There is a system there which anybody can pick up and follow. And then it takes you to leadership, from personal leadership to leadership in an outside space. Yeah.
So when you, now that when you meet women and you want to have them be leaders in their own life.
Yes.
So as a starting step, what would be your one tip for us women?
The one big tip that I think has to come from and through this book and through the work that I have done is that you have to get used to the idea of the unknown and stop being perfectionist, because this is where most women, because of their multiple responsibility
roles,
kind of life that most women live. Because I myself, I'm a mother, I'm a wife, I'm running businesses, I'm doing the work that I'm doing, I'm an author. So it's like a multiple thing. So we have to stop thinking about perfectionism for a while.
I see.
And start to embrace the new stuff that comes into life and start building our lives around that. Because we want those perfection states in our lives and everything has to be okay with everybody, which is sometimes very difficult to do. We have to find the optimum level. Not the perfect level. So if I can differentiate between the two, we have to find the optimum at any given point of time rather than being perfectionist at every point of time,
right.
Which is where I think all women struggle. So my one big tip for them is stop being perfectionist, just be optimum at any given point of time.
So did you find it difficult to be an Indian in Indonesia to reach the pinnacle that you have?
Difficult? No, I think I made friends with people like yourself and many others over here. And basically, I just sort of kept learning and kept moving forward. You got to keep up the momentum because there's no one way to get to someplace.
Right.
This is another tip that I want to tell everybody, that success doesn't come in a straight line. So we have to understand that very clearly. And you have to do tons of things which may not be actually anywhere in the plan. So you start off, there's something which you can put into a plan. There's something that you can never know what will happen. So likewise in Indonesia, I found various things to sort of learn. Number one, the language, just to get to know people, get my way around here. It wasn't initially not very easy, but eventually not too bad.
Yeah.
Language was easy, made friends with people like yourself. And